Thanks for staying with us. Now, we're taking inspiration from the world's biggest style icons in fashion today.
We are indeed. It's not you, Ian. Jackie O.
Ooh.
To posh Beckham stylist Judy Gilroy has you covered. Good morning to you, Judy.
Good morning.
Jackie O, of course, is one of the biggest, the world's biggest style icons forever, really, isn't she?
Yes, she is. I mean, I think the classic style never goes out of fashion. And the Killishy Irish Tatler style icon competition is coming up at the Curra next week. So that's why we're taking inspiration today.
So what have people been asked to do then?
So this is effectively a best dressed competition.
Okay.
But there's great prizes for female style icon, male style icon. You can win shopping sprees, stays at the Killishy Hotel, you name it. So great prizes.
Okay.
Well, let's have a look at your interpretation of Jackie O.
Oh, yes.
Very Jackie O.
Yes, it is. Absolutely.
So I have been shopping in Nace for the occasion. This one is from Aria Boutique. And I quite like this dress because it's hitting a lot of notes. This is very similar to what we've seen Jackie O wearing, but also this is something that you can wear to communion, confirmation, a wedding. So this is the kind of dress that I think that you'll buy and you'll have for years.
And it's all about the accessories, isn't it, Anna? The little white gloves and the pearls.
Really
like this Jackie O,
These pearls are real pearls.
Really?
So they're 149 euros, so they are a bit of a spend. But great gift, and they are real pearls.
I thought you were saying 149,000 for real pearls.
Real pearls, really?
Real pearls, yeah. So real pearls for 149 euro. I like pearls. I think pearls are very timeless. You're taking your cues from Jackie O. They're never going to go out of style, and they're the kind of thing you'll have for a long time. So if I was buying them, this is the kind of pair I would buy.
Do you think the movie recently as well has kind of popularized the whole Jackie O style?
It really has, and I think that we're going to see it coming back into fashion a little bit more again. There's so much talk over the movie, and she's such fantastic style. Women love her.
Yeah, and it's very figure flattering as well, isn't it?
So this is very Jackie in that it's got the bow at the waist, the shape, the pearls, and then we've just added the little details, the white gloves. I'm not sure if every woman is going to wear a pair of white gloves with the dress, but we've given it a whirl today. They're just 20 quid.
Not if you have kids with lollipops, you won't anyway.
No, definitely not. But for a day like that at the races or a style afternoon, why not?
Exactly, and I mean, where you've got a best dress competition, you want to put your best foot forward.
Yeah.
I think judges look out for something where you're doing something a little bit different and you're not playing by the rules.
Okay, well, we're not forgetting the lads this morning.
Yes.
You'll be glad to hear.
Channel your inner Conor McGregor.
And he is someone who definitely does not play by the rules. I mean, Conor McGregor's style is definitely out there, but he does it, he carries it off with aplomb.
Panache.
Yes, yeah.
He has made the loud check suit so popular.
He has. And I believe that this suit is from Richie Whelan's menswear in Nace, and I believe that he gets a lot of gentlemen in asking for the Conor McGregor suit. Yeah, so in the picture that we just saw there, he had worn the navy tie and the kind of navy toned shirt as well.
Yeah.
We've put in a white shirt because I think it's a little bit more wearable that way, and we've gone for the burgundy tones. So this suit is a three-piece suit, really good price points with Richie Whelan's menswear, and they did the tailoring as well, which is important when it comes to a suit, isn't it?
It's what you're thinking.
No, it's beautiful material, beautiful cut. I love the check. I love the lightness of the material. Mm. It's really good for, you know, summer coming in and wherever you're going in it. But it's just the cut, the tailoring on that is just gorgeous.
It's beautiful.
If I had Mike's body, of course, I could do that as well.
I thought there was a bush coming. There's no bush.
No bush. I wear that in a heartbeat. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So big fan of this look. I think it's very similar to what Conor wears as well.
Yes, it is indeed. Yes.
And we've just gone for the nice little touches. I mean, tie, 25 quid, not expensive. And this is an easy wear. And with a three-piece suit, as you know yourself, Ian, you can wear all three pieces, you can wear two pieces.
You can break them up.
Or you can break them up and wear the blazer.
One thing there, Mike, a gentleman never has his bottom button, his waistcoat tied.
Never tied. Really?
Yeah,
is that a rule?
No, that's the thing. It goes back to the days where they had the old pocket watches.
Okay.
And the way they take them in and out, so
give
for some reason.
Bit of movement.
Bit of movement, exactly, yeah.
We can also do a bit of movement, can't we?
Who are you telling?
Hence ruching. That's our equivalent of ruching.
They haven't invented male Spanx yet, have they?
That's your moneymaker.
Yeah, there
great
we go.
Great idea.
Now,
so next, you can't have a style icon feature and not mention Victoria Beckham.
Very true.
She is the queen of
style. There we
style.
Go. Yes, great shot.
So, this stripes, we're seeing a lot of them for spring, summer. They are not going to be to everybody's taste. This is obviously a very full-on look. Yeah. This is a very high-fashion look, and this is more of a premium brand
and
as well.
And Arsene, you're the spit of posh Beckham in that.
The hair, particularly.
Look, that little wink that she gave you, that says it all. Yeah. That says
Shut
it
up,
all.
Doctor.
Yeah. I'm not sure about the whole thing together. I like it.
The mixing and matching.
But it's just all too much for me.
Yes, yeah. And I can understand that. And I mean, I think the thing with this look is from Emporium Clue in Nace in Kildare. And it's very much an aspirational boutique. They do stock premium brands like this one, Mantu. So it's not going to be in everybody's price range.
No.
But I like the idea of it, of taking inspiration from Victoria or the big fashion labels and seeing what you can do with it.
And
for me, I would probably
now,
mix and match.
But a simple white top with those trousers could be beautiful.
Or the shirt with a pair of jeans.
Yeah.
So it's about taking the idea and reworking it and making it your own.
You get one wear out of that outfit and then you split it into different bits, is that
exactly.
it?
Exactly. Oh, you'd have to.
You'd have to.
Have to. For the rest
to
of your life.
To get bang for your
for
buck.
For the price. It would be
I'll just mortgage the house to buy a dress, yeah.
I'll still be wearing it in the nursing home.
To buy a rig out, yeah, exactly.
But it is a beautiful boutique if anybody has, like, if you're looking for that
for special
piece.
Pieces.
Or a special piece, yes. Yeah.